Hello, and welcome to day three of the Institute of Policy Studies Singapore Perspectives 2021. I'm Ong So Chin, IPS Deputy Director for Strategic Planning and External Relations. This year's Singapore Perspectives is unique as it has four sessions, three online and one hybrid plenary session, which will close the event on Monday. I'm sure many of you have enjoyed the energetic debates that came out of the first two online installments last week. Today is the last online session, and it promises to be an exciting one as well, with three forums all centered on the theme Politics and Governance to Build a Democratic Society. This morning's discussion, the first of the day, is on multilateralism and global cooperation, an important topic seeing as the world is in the midst of an extremely polarized era, which has brought to the fore the worst of nativist and tribal instincts. Yet, while the effects of the pandemic have fed protectionist sentiments in nations, they've also created opportunities for collaboration. I'd like to encourage everyone to ask questions via Pigeonhole and the question submission section on this forum's page. But to please keep your comments civil, respectful, and focused on the topic at hand. Moderating this morning's discussion is Associate Professor Eugene Tan from the School of Law of the Singapore Management University. Eugene specializes in constitutional and administrative law. He's also a frequent political commentator and a former nominated Member of Parliament. I'd like to welcome you, Eugene, and hand the panel over to you.
Thank you very much, So Chin. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Forum 7, where we will look at the issue of multilateralism and global cooperation. I think it goes without saying that both multilateralism and global cooperation are in retreat. The lack of a clear global leader, has, of course, made things rather difficult in terms of trying to deal with the common challenges that face mankind. So whether we're looking at the global pandemic or whether we are talking about climate change, international trade, all these are very much dependent, on a thriving and workable, multilateral system. I think it's important to understand why Singapore has succeeded because of the multilateral system. That ensures, that small states like Singapore, would be able to plan, with certainty, and also be able to ensure, that there is international rule of law. But I think what is crucial about multilateralism is certainly the expectations of reciprocity among the different members of a multilateral system. And of course, we mustn't forget multilateralism operates within the very important principle of state sovereignty, right? So the idea that territorial states have possession of territory and are able to exclude others from it. But it also means that multilateralism requires that openness of heart and minds, and also the recognition, that ultimately the benefits that members obtain, in aggregate over time, would